Chef's Table, we explore home cooking with a twist at Social Eatz, where Top Chef contender Angelo Sosa gives us an exclusive cooking class.
Chef Sosa, thank you so much for having me at Social Eatz.
Awesome, Tanya. I'm really excited. Thanks for coming in.
Oh, my God. It's my pleasure. So we're here in this beautiful new restaurant in Midtown Manhattan. And I love the concept of Social Eatz. Do you want to explain to me a little bit about it?
Sure. So Social Eatz is basically American comfort food with an Asian twist.
I know you're going to make us a couple things today.
I am.
What are you going to make? What's the first one?
This is my interpretation of a taco. It's an Asian version of a taco.
All right. Well, I'm going to leave you to it because it's a little bit crammed.
It's a little hot in here.
It's a little hot, you know. I'm starting to wilt.
Okay.
So you go to it.
So we're behind the scenes now in Social Eatz Kitchen. As you can see, there's action going on. First, what we're gonna do now for this fish, the tilapia taco, is we're gonna basically toast our spices. Start with the largest spice first, because it's gonna take more time to extract what's called the essential oils or the volatile oils, and that's where all the flavor's at. So I added my chipotle here. I love using chipotle. Just that smokiness and the depth of the pepper is just awesome. We're gonna add some coriander as well. Coriander is the seedling of comes from cilantro, okay? Indigenous, all these spices are, other than the chipotle, are indigenous to Southeast Asia. We're gonna add some cumin. What you really wanna do first is you want to toast the spices really, really soft. You wanna release those oils, natural oils. As a chef, you have to think of yourself as an extractor. You don't wanna mask the flavors, or you wanna basically release them and pull them out, okay? Here, come and check this out, smell that. That's amazing. What we're gonna do next is add some paprika. Once again, this is just gonna add a little bit more smokiness and accentuate the chipotle. Delicious. In any of my spice blends, and this is one little key note, add a little salt. A little salt goes a long way, and salt is an extractor as well. It heightens and enhances flavor, okay? So what we're gonna do here, we're actually gonna take a mortar and pestle. This is a great way as opposed to using a spice grinder. I love working with my hands and really filling the food. We're just gonna chop, mesh up these spices, okay? And you can actually just take your hand, put it like so, flat, leave a little hole here, and just pound the spices like so. So we're basically gonna take a little bit of this spice mixture. We're gonna season the fish. And I actually don't even mind. I mean, if you wanna take a look, you can see the whole cumin. I like getting that burst and that pop right in your mouth, okay? I'm gonna take a little fish sauce. Add a little oil. There you have it. Just let this sit for about 10 minutes. If you wanna be super, super generous, you can marinate it for at least an hour. Next, we're gonna jump over here and make a guacamole, okay? I use a nice ripe Haas avocado, okay? We're just gonna cut this right in half. When you open the avocado, then you wanna remove the core, like so, okay? I like scoring the avocado in its jacket, and then we're just gonna spoon it out. There we go, it's that easy. Add a little salt, okay? Add some red onion, cilantro. We're gonna take a little lime juice, and we're just gonna jazz this up. Next, we're just gonna mix this guacamole around. You could even stop here and serve this with chips. I'm gonna add a little bit more acidic, more acid, more lime juice, a pinch of salt. Always remember, taste your food. Delish. All right, we're gonna jump over here again. Basically, this tilapia's been marinating. We're just gonna give it a nice flip to make sure the marination is on all the sides. Just gonna add this right on the plancha here. And just sear it on all sides. Just gonna lightly sear it on both sides. Okay, there we go. So next is the plating. At Social Eatz, we actually make our own tortillas and we use fresh maseca. Maseca is basically corn flour, okay? Gonna take a little of the guacamole. I love using chopsticks. And add the fish right on top. I love heat, so I'm gonna add a little bit, I'm gonna jazz this up with a little bit more jalapeno, and then just finish this beautiful fish off. Some cilantro. And there you have it, my version of an Asian taco.
Coming up, it's Chef Angelo Sosa's award-winning Asian fusion burger.